you know what the writer of Hebrews says? You know what the writer of Hebrews says? Light of the fact that God is a good God. Light of the fact that God is a great God. Light of the fact that God won't let you down. But you better realize that the devil is trying everything he can. Yeah, he's trying to hold you back. The devil is trying to do everything he can, trying to keep you down. The devil is doing everything he can, trying to get you to walk around with your head hung down. The devil is trying to do everything he can to get you to turn back. But the writer of Hebrews said, let us then make every effort to enter into that rest. Devil, you can throw the best shot you got. And I come by to let you know the devil is a liar. Because greater is he that is with me than he that is in the world. And devil, the dumbest joy that I have, I come to serve you notice. That the world didn't give it to me. 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 So I be damned if the world. God, I'm taking it away. Be patient with me. Because God is not through with me yet. Oh yes, please be patient with me. Oh yes, because see, I said things that I shouldn't have said. And the reality is that I might still say some stuff that I shouldn't say. So you gotta please be patient with me. But I'm so glad that I got me a great high priest that's already paid the price for me. Yes, yes, and God knows what I'm going through. You know what? You know what? Hebrews says, realize that you got a great high priest. Realize that you got somebody who paid the ultimate price. And all I got to do is just now hold on to that faith that I possess. Because see, my faith says that in spite of my sins, that I serve the God that was able to wash me whiter than snow. Yes, yes, Jesus knows about my struggles. Yes, Jesus knows about my weakness. Yes, and he is the great high priest. And as the great high priest, he never did sin. As the great high priest, he never did go astray. As the great high priest, he lived the way God wanted him to live. As the great high priest, he died for my sins. But oh no, he is not a great high priest that is out of touch with how I feel. He is not a great high priest that doesn't know what I'm going through. Because the Bible says he is able to empathize. He feels my struggles. He feels my pain. I think that's what the folk of old used to say. There is not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else can heal all my soul diseases. No, not one. No, not one. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that Jesus knows all about my struggles. And he will guide until the day is done. Yes, I've gone astray. Yes, I've messed up. Yes, but I'm so glad that his blood covers my fault. Yes, and the good news is, yes, I might have messed up. And so what is the answer if you're messed up? What if the answer if you're gone astray? What if the answer if you haven't dotted every I and crossed every T? What if the answer if you're messed up in life? Yes, it says, let me tell you, all you got to do, verse 16, is just pray about it. And when you pray about it, God will show up. And it says that all now that we've got to do is let us come boldly, let us come with confidence to the throne of grace. Yes, I can come boldly in spite of my sins. I can come with confidence that I serve a God that's a God of another chance. I can certainly come with confidence with the assurance that can't nobody do it like Jesus. Can't nobody do it like the Lord. Anybody here can show enough testify. I had a talk with Jesus and he made it all right. And not only can I come to the throne with confidence, but the writer says two things that God will provide right there at the throne. First of all, the good God that I serve. When I come boldly to his throne, when I come with confidence to his throne, the first thing that he will provide is God will give me some mercy. And I don't know about you, but I thank God for his mercy. In my life, that I have to say, Lord, have mercy on me. Because God, I know I messed up, but have mercy on me. God, I need me another chance. Have mercy on me. And I wish I had somebody here at the Cornerstone Baptist Church that knew something about mercy. Jesus.